Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Julia Rae. I make beauty and lifestyle videos here on my channel, as well as some pregnancy and soon some motherhood videos as well, because I am 38 weeks pregnant. Holy cow, I can't believe that we're already so close to the end. In today's video, I wanted to do a quick short and sweet nursery tour, just because, again, we are exactly 2 weeks away from our scheduled C-section date. So I just wanted to quickly show this space, film it, record it for our memories while it's all clean and tidy. And yeah, I thought it would be fun to pop it up on YouTube for you guys as well, because we are super, super pleased with how it's turned out. It's very cozy. It's very warm. I would consider it gender neutral. And yeah, I'm just like super happy with this space. I love spending time in here and I wanted to share it with you guys. So we are here in our upstairs hallway, just outside of our master bedroom, and this is baby boy's room. So this is what you see when the door is open. And I'll just kind of take you around the room. So first things first, I wanted these right beside the changing table and right by the door. These are just the two little laundry baskets that I picked up. They are actually from Dollarama. I think they were $3 or $4 each. I really like them because they were so inexpensive. They have like a coating on the inside that is wipeable, and I just figured for baby's clothing that is bound to get covered in lots of interesting and exciting and disgusting liquids and substances, those would be a really good option for laundry baskets, just because if they do get really disgusting, I can just toss them. I really like that they have handles as well. So yeah, they were a great price. They're going to be very functional. I really also just thought the black and white and the polka dots was a super cutie patootie pattern. And then moving over here, we have our... Also, guys, just a side note, I'm sorry I'm so happy, but 38 weeks, almost 39 weeks pregnant, and I'm a huffy lady. My lungs don't have a lot of room left. but we have our changing table here as well. I wanted it, again, by the door so that we can just pop in here and change him and have everything we need. You know, quickly and easily accessible. So this is the Gulliver changing table from IKEA. So we have everything we would need for a quick change right at the front here. So we've currently got newborn diapers in two different sizes. So in case he's really tiny, and then just some regular newborn diapers from Costco. We've got lots of little receiving blankets here. The idea with those being here is that we can use them as burp cloths, but also pop them up on here just to kind of make this a little less chilly and a little softer on his back when we're changing him. And then if the receiving blanket gets dirty during the change, we can just toss it right into the laundry basket. We've got some wipes here. I've got backup wipes back there. There is also a box back there of, that box has the refills, the garbage bag refills for the diaper genie. That is right here as well. And then we just have some little peepee-teepees, you know, baby boy problems. And then some lotion, diaper cream, all that good stuff. And then down here we just have a basket full of extra little like pacifiers, clips, lotions, toys. It's just like a random assortment that I wasn't really sure what to do with. So I'm not sure that that basket will always live there, but I've popped it there for now just so we can quickly reach in and take a look through and grab stuff if we need anything. Again, a diaper genie. We got this for our baby shower. It is the elite diaper genie. I'm not sure if that really matters, but we like it so far. Not that we've used it yet, but I like that it's kind of like low profile and kind of hidden here, and you can't really see the garbage can when you first walk into the room. So here's what this area looks like from a little bit further back. So this is actually something that my mother-in-law found, I think she just found it on the side of the road, or maybe it was a garage sale find. I'm not 100% sure, but she picked it up in her hometown years ago. We've actually had it for a really long time. She refinished it, put little cute hooks on it, and I thought it went really, really well in here. Our theme is kind of like greens and really, really muted blues and grays, with a lot of like wood tones and white, if that makes sense. And I just thought it was super, super cute. And I really like that it has these little hooks here because I can always hang up, you know, the next day's outfit or something if I'm ever trying to be super organized with my life. And then I love owls, so we put these little owl hooks here as well. I'm not sure if these are practical, if they'll stay, just because as he, you know, becomes a little more mobile and able to grab at things, I'm not sure if we'll want those there near where we're changing him. It might be more of a hassle, but for now I think it looks super, super, super cute, and I like that it looks a little vintage, a little aged. I really like pieces that have a little bit more character, and since this is an IKEA heavy space, I think that adds a nice little touch. Moving over to this little far wall corner of the room, we have an IKEA Hemnes dresser. This is the three drawer IKEA Hemnes dresser, and this is where I'm keeping all of the clothing that currently fits him. So everything we'll use from 0 to 3 months, and then I do have some 3 to 6 month clothing in there as well. And then this lamp, I'm gonna try and show you. Let me turn off the light. I wonder if that'll make it easier to see. Not really. So again, I really wanted a lot of like earthy tones in here, so I really, really like this kind of wood effect lamp. It is from Home Depot. It's part of their signature collection, so they always have it. And we have no overhead lighting in this room, so we needed a lot of table lighting and wall sconces, which I'll show you on the other side of the room as well. This is a little pumpkin that I got him, even though he won't be here in time for Halloween. And Canadian Thanksgiving is past. I have it turned around right now because we're not sharing his name until he's born and it has the first letter, or the first initial of his first name on there. But it's super, super cute, and I just wanted to keep it there. Mostly though, I want to keep the surface clear of clutter just to make our lives easy. Then on this wall, we have this super adorable wallpaper. Again, I'm obsessed with owls. This wallpaper is mostly for me. I've shared the link to this wallpaper in a previous vlog, but I will pop it in the description box down below as well. It's peel and stick. Sean was able to put it up in about an hour. He said it was super, super easy to do. And it's something that we can peel off once we get tired of it, because I don't think we'll want it up for forever. Or as, you know, this kid grows up and develops his own tastes and preferences. And then we opted for these really cute little blue-gray curtains. They have this really subtle chevron pattern in them. They're from IKEA, and I just think they're really, really cute. I still need to hem these. I'm just not sure. Like, if you can see down there, I hemmed the shears, but I have not hemmed the blue curtains, so we'll see if I can muster up the energy in the next 2 weeks to do that before he comes into our lives. Over in this corner of the room is kind of my little breastfeeding station, the little chill out station, if you will. This is a Lazy Boy recliner. It's not a rocker, which is kind of a bummer. We did get a rocker off of Facebook Marketplace that we've popped into our master bedroom. So I don't know, we might switch the two at some point, but for now this lives here. I think it really, really matches kind of like our earthy, comfy, cozy theme. And the chair itself is incredibly comfortable. And yeah, I just love this chair so much. It's very, very old. It was a hand-me-down from a family member years ago. The pillow is an oldie, but a goodie from IKEA. I really like it because it gives a little bit of back support because it is kind of a deeper chair. And then up here, we have a little bookshelf with some of the books that we were gifted at our baby shower. We have been given so many books. This is just a few of them that I could fit up here, some of our absolute favorites. So this is a shelf from IKEA, and I ended up painting it the wall color. I just thought that was a really cute contrast against the white and gray wallpaper. Kind of draws attention to it, and I just liked having the bookshelf, you know, right behind the chair so we can be sitting here, grab a book, read it to him, pop it back up there. And then over here is a very old little dresser that I got from Home Sense years ago. It used to be like an aqua blue, and I just painted it a white color that I just had on hand in the basement because I thought it went a little nicer in here. And this has an assortment of things. This has like little sensory items and toys in it. This drawer just has some extra wipes, some burp cloths, and some vitamin D drops. I'll probably have to organize this a little bit better at some point in the future. And then this is full of snacks. I was advised by many people to have lots and lots of snacks beside wherever I was going to be breastfeeding. Cross your fingers for me that breastfeeding works out. So we just went to Costco and got a bunch of healthy-ish, protein-rich snacks and have just been keeping them in there. And then this drawer is empty, but I'm going to keep some plastic bottles of water in here just so that when I'm sitting here, if I forgot to bring a water bottle in, I'll always have water right there. And then up here, this is something that was gifted to us from my in-laws, I guess I should say. They're not Sean's in-laws, they're his parents. And I just love it so much. I love it so much. When I was a kid, bunnies were kind of my thing. And I kind of like that throwback. And he perfectly fits our gray and blue and green theme. And then we have our little sound machine. This is just something we found on Amazon. We put it on our baby registry, Dream Egg. And we actually love it. Like, I would highly, highly recommend this. I think it's very affordable too. Like, I think under $40. So I'll quickly mention our sconces because again, we have no overhead lighting in here. We put dimmer light bulbs in these because I wanted them to not be super, super bright in baby's eyes when I, you know, if we're sitting here, but we'll probably change that out. Not that you can tell, they look very, very vibrant in this video, but these are super, super affordable sconces from Home Depot. They were $35 each. I have one on either side of the crib. This is our Wyze Cam, which is going to be our baby monitor, or, you know, part of our baby's monitoring system. But I still need to find a way to, I want to like hide the cord and kind of feed it along here so that you don't see it. So if anyone has any tips for how to do that, I might just like nail it into the wall there. Okay, and so this is what the far wall looks like. This is where baby boy will be living most of his newborn life. the painting is something that I did. I'm still not super in love with it, but I just wanted to kind of bring our colors into this room. I had the canvas lying around, so it's just a really simple nest. And then I tried to bring in like our blues and our muted greens and a lot of like creams and whites. So for now, I'm happy with it. Sean has finally been able to firmly secure it to the wall, so I'm not worried about it falling on the crib or anything like that. Here's the matching sconce. I love how cozy the sconces look on either side of the crib, and I really like that once we transition him into like a day bed, they'll still look really cute up there on either side of the bed. So I think they'll work for a really long time. And again, they were super, super affordable. And the crib is, again, the Gulliver crib. So it's the same collection as the changing table. Super, super, super affordable. Right now, we have this little bassinet in here, which will actually go into our bedroom once baby boy arrives. It's meant to kind of sit between you on top of your bed, and I have his first little sleep sack in here that he'll be using. Gives me all the feels when I see this in here because I can't believe there's gonna be a little human, our little baby in here so incredibly soon. And then I have a little bunny blanket that we were gifted just hanging out in here as well. I know it can't stay there once we actually have him sleeping in here, but I just kind of have been keeping it there for now. But then all the rest of the bedding, we picked up a few packs of these fitted crib sheets from IKEA. They're just simple, white, 100% cotton. This little crib sheet has little white polka dots on it. Not sure if the camera is picking them up. Again, that's IKEA. I just thought it was cute. Hide some of the dust bunnies under there. And then this little guy is called the Snoozy Pod from the brand Halo. This is something that we were gifted for our baby shower. It's kind of like a sound machine. It also projects these little lights up onto the ceiling. It's super, super adorable. And basically, it's like a paddle that has been, like, it goes under here and it fits underneath the actual crib mattress, and you can control it from your phone or directly from this thing. and it just kind of like really, really subtly vibrates, and it's meant to kind of soothe them back to sleep. So we'll see. We'll see if he likes it, if it works. I'm pretty excited about it. And then over here on this side of the crib, we were gifted a ton of adorable, gorgeous baby blankets and sleep sacks for all different ages. So the bottom is lots of baby blankets, and then the top basket has lots of sleep sacks. I'm not sure. I think eventually we'll use these in here as toy storage, but for now, I just like the way they look in here. I needed somewhere to put them that wasn't tucked into the closet, because this bad boy is packed full. And yeah, for now, that's where they're gonna live. And then I just have my nursing pillow thrown up here just so I can grab it when we head to the hospital. But when we get home from the hospital, once he has arrived, again, the nursing pillow and that little bassinet in there will probably live in our bedroom. I think the only other thing to mention would be the rug, and it's really nothing special. It was just a little end of the roll find from Home Depot. It was about 40 bucks Canadian. So we picked it up for in here, and it's nice. It's really, 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 really soft. I'm not sure how practical a white rug is in a baby's nursery, so we will see how long it stays pristine and white, and we will appreciate it until it is no longer practical in this space. The last thing I'll mention, I don't think I've mentioned it yet, is the wall color. It is called Clary Sage by the brand Bear, and we love it. It looks very, very soft during the day and a little bit more vibrant at night, but overall, yeah, we just think it's so, so pretty in here. So I thought since we're here with the camera, I could do a little bump update. So this is how we're looking at 38, pretty much 39 weeks. That's crazy. I feel like I don't even look that big. I'm not sure. But this has pretty much been my uniform, just pajama pants, worn super low, and my old oversized sweaters. Just because comfort is the name of the game at this point. I'm so out of breath. Just from, I feel like, barely talking. But yes, that is it. That is all for this video. I really just wanted to film a quick tour of the space before it gets, you know, used and lived in, while it's still all tidy and freshly put together. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you are a seasoned parent and you have any suggestions for things we should add to the space or things maybe we should take out of the space, let me know in the comments down below. I'm really interested to know, because again, we're doing this all for the very first time. But yeah, sometimes I just come in here and I like to sit here. It's crazy to think that we will be meeting baby boy in less than 13 days, and maybe even sooner if I go into labor, if he decides he wants to come all on his own a little bit sooner. But our scheduled C-section is on November 11th. So yeah, if you guys want to continue following along with our journey, you can subscribe to this channel, say hi down below. Don't forget to hit that bell notification if you are subscribed, just to make sure that my videos are showing up in your YouTube subscription feed. That is it. That is all for me today. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of this gorgeous day, even though for me right now it is very gloomy outside. And I will see you hopefully in my next video. Bye guys.